Up to news time, the student, Neil Miggins, remained in critical care at a high dependency unit at a Georgetown public hospital. His devastated mother, Barbara Miggins, told Capital News she was notified of the incident when the ambulance arrived at her home.
So I ran out, and when I ran out, I saw him in the ambulance, my little son, Neil Miggins, with a scissors in his head. And he was in and out of consciousness, but when I talked with him, he told me that he ran down some stairs and jumped at not a school child. And the child just feel the impact and feel scissors in his head. When the police came to the hospital and see me at West Ham Hospital, the police told me that the fellow said that my son troubling and how he just shied the scissors and he just get passion and shied the scissors in his son's head.
The woman said that an x-ray taken revealed the stab wound was deep and that it was touching some of her son's brain tissues. She said that after being transferred from the West Demerara Hospital, her son had to be taken into the theater for immediate surgery.
He got to go on surgery now, and they said that may have to take a bone out from his ear. Said that may have to take a bone out of his ear because it gone past the skull. The scissors gone down past the skull. They take CT and X-ray. That's why the reason why best transfer him to Georgetown. So they told me that I have to sign a form that is a death and life situation, and I have to sign the form that the scissors can come out of his head.
The mother of five children says she always encouraged them to avoid violence in all its forms.
Children are not supposed to be this violence. I just always pray and talk to my children a lot. Even get the church involved in my children in life, because I believe that children must be children. Children must not be adults.
This incident follows Tuesday's fatal stabbing of 14-year-old Rupununi student Camelus Arthur by another 15-year-old male student. According to police, the two students had an altercation on the playfield, which resulted in the stabbing of Arthur. Called City Head teacher at Potentia Secondary proved futile. Leroy Adolphus, Capital News.